Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to use ProPresenter for short-form video. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where, of course, I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever had, like, a short-form video and you wanted to put a transcript onto it real quickly and easily without going through a little bit at a time in a video editor, go ahead, like, subscribe, click the little bell icon, all that fun stuff. So, I've been toying around with short-form video. Most of them are vertical. And it occurred to me, of course, because ProPresenter is a thing that I do a lot of work with, that this might be a helpful tip for a lot of people. One thing I do want to say is I'm violating one of the things that I tell people not to do all the time. And you could get around this by starting out and editing the video to make it the vertical video that you need it to be, and then adding in the lower thirds, or not the lower thirds, the transcript later. But as we look at this, you'll see that ProPresenter is a little slow and a little laggy, and the reason for that is because I'm using the full-size video, trying to make it vertical, and ProPresenter just doesn't like that. So, with that said, let's head over to my computer, and I'll show you what I did. So, here we are in ProPresenter, and the first thing that I did was I brought in the transcript. So I went to right up here, click New Presentation, and for theme here, I have created a theme that's a vertical video theme. So you could just go into the theme editor, make it an appropriate size, put the transcript text wherever you think that it will be, etc. Just make sure that it's set up vertically. If you want to do this for a horizontal video, you can do that as well, by the way. So I did that. So I'm going to select that. And then let's call this video pencil tutorial, because that's what this video is that I'm going to bring that into. And let's bring this into the current playlist, put it in an appropriate library, etc. For size, notice that I already have a screen that is a vertical screen. Hint, hint, it's this guy. So that's the one that I've chosen here so that it has the reverse resolution of 1080 by 1920 instead of 1920 by 1080. So that's one piece of the puzzle here. So I'm going to click New, and then let's go into Reflow right here, and I'm just going to paste in the transcript. So let me, instead of just doing a regular paste, I'm going to copy, or go to Edit, sorry, and then paste, and then over here, paste and match style. And notice how it's pretty legible. But what I'm going to want to do is real quickly take this and split it by at least sentences. So click there, option return, I think it's alt enter on Windows. But you know, I could just really quickly go through this here and get it to split really quickly. Okay? So that's there. Now I go back into show mode, and you'll notice that I've got these ready to go. I would continue on throughout all the transcript that I want. Basically, I grabbed this transcript from YouTube, put it into ChatGPT, and had it correct capitalization and punctuation. Anyway, do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. Next, what I did was I brought in the video that I want to deal with, and notice that this is a regular horizontal video, so it's going to be a little laggy because ProPresenter doesn't like squishing stuff down that's larger, and it doesn't like trying to change the aspect ratio too much, and I'm doing basically that. So I've brought that in. And let me show you some of the things that I set it to. First, I want it to be a background so that it continues when I go from one slide to another, because that's what backgrounds do. I want it to stop so that once I get to the end of it, it's done. And that's good to go. So, oh, one more thing. Right click. And for scale, I'm going to do scale to fill. Now, down here, it's filling a vertical space, so it's, you know, it's not going to show me anything odd. But when I drag it onto the vertical here, then we will see it showing up a little bit differently. So, there, that's good to go there. Now, I need to figure out a way to record this. Well, ProPresenter has that built in, so I can go right over here to live and go to capture settings, and I'll show you the settings that I've already set up to do this. And H.264, that's going to give me a smallish video that's more compatible, so that's what I want to do. And notice under encoding, I clicked on custom encoding and I made a 1080 by 1920, 30 frames per second one, which is basically the same as this with 20 megabits per second, 30 frames per second at 20 megabits per second. So that's good. I also went ahead and saved that as a preset up here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the capture and then go through this like this is a song. Only I'm going to listen to, in this case, myself and what I'm saying and just follow along. Now, as I say, ProPresenter doesn't like resizing things, so it's going to be a little laggy, but I think that you'll get the idea of what's going on here. So let's start capture. Oh, and I realized that I made a mistake in that I also had a look set up so that it will set up look appropriate here. Let me get rid of this key here. So, and then I'm going to preview that right here. So, now I'm going to have to cut off the beginning of this, but that's okay. That's an easy operation in a video editor, so I'm going to click on that, and we'll get it started. And notice how it is laggy, but I'm... And you can see it right here, it's very laggy. So once I get done, I'm just going to click the pause here and then click up here and stop the capture. And so that is a really quick way that you can go ahead and make this into a vertical video with a transcript baked right into the video, so you don't have to depend on their transcript, which, yeah, could be iffy for social media like TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, even YouTube has shorts, so that's a good way to do that. Again, as I say, once you do the appropriate editing there. So, if you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/pro7 and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.